Merry Christmas to you all. What a delight it is to gather here in the sanctuary for this service of lessons and carols, to hear the story of Jesus' birth, to sing our songs, to speak our words, and to be in community in the midst of it. What a gift it is. I'm Pastor Christy Webb. For those of you I have not yet gotten to meet, I serve here as the pastor, and I'm so glad that we are all together this day. A few notes on the service before we begin. The first is that we ask you all to continue to wear your masks for the duration of service. This enables us to speak the common words communally, as well as to sing the hymns. You, of course, will be able to take down your mask when you are eating communion or when you're partaking in the Lord's Supper, the body of Christ and the blood of Christ. If you'd like to participate in communion, when you came in, you should have received a cup of juice or wine and a wafer. If you have not yet gotten that, they're available at a table at the back. Some people are joining us on Facebook Live. If that is you, we invite you to find bread or cracker, juice or wine so that you might participate in communion with us. You also will want to have a candle with you. And here's some details on that candle. The candle lighting will be at the end of the service. When you light your candle, we encourage that the lit candle stays upright and the unlit candle tips into the lit candle to be lit, and then you pass it down the row. So the lit candle stays upright, the unlit candle tips. And at the end, when we sing Joy to the World, you'll extinguish your candle. You can take your mask down at that time to blow it out. If you're uncomfortable taking your mask down to blow it out, that's okay. On your way out, on a table on your left-hand side as you exit, there will be some sand, and you're welcome to just snuff your candle out in that sand. If all of that makes you uncomfortable, there may still be some electric candles available for you in the back. If you are a young person in worship this day and you'd like to participate in our procession parade, our Christmas parade, we invite you during the prelude to head to the back of the sanctuary and see Deacon David Webb, and he will give you some instructions. But what a wonderful day of celebration we have before us, and we prepare our hearts for that celebration by listening to the prelude.
for the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace. For the throne of David and his kingdom he will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. This is the word of the Lord.
Our story takes place in a little town, 10 miles south of Jerusalem. The houses are all gathered together on the top of hills, like people all huddled together on a dark night sharing bread. So they call this little town the House of Bread, or in the language of the Bible, Bethlehem. In the center of this very little town, there is a small inn with an even smaller barn behind it. A tired donkey is eating some straw near a cow that is already sleeping. All is still, all is quiet.
Now our Holy Family reading. In those days a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that while all the world should be registered, this was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
In the distance, two travelers are making their way up the road. It is a tiny family, two people who have just become partners. The mother has not given birth yet, but it looks like the baby might be born any minute. The father is trying to help the mother keep walking, even though they are both very tired. They have been walking for 6 days, so that they can be counted and the emperor can take their money as tax. As they come into a little town, they cannot find a place to sleep. There are no rooms or beds anywhere. They decide to sleep with the animals because they cannot find any other place to sleep, and they are so tired. The stars seem to twinkle in the sky. All of the creation holds its breath. Suddenly, from the barn, there is a tiny cry. After all of the walking and waiting and struggling and pain, the mother feeds the baby and the father makes a small bed. In a fed box filled with straw, when the baby has eaten, the mother gently wraps the baby in a blanket and lays him in the straw so that they can all sleep.
The next lesson is from Luke chapter 2, the shepherds. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told to them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them.
Outside the little town are a small group of shepherds watching their sheep. They are huddled together like the houses of the little town. They are like a little family of their own, gathered together, trying to stay warm and awake, watching their sheep. For them, it is a night like any other night. It is cold and they are tired from a day of very hard work. Suddenly, there was so much light in the sky that it hurt their eyes. They were afraid. Their hearts were beating so loudly. When they could hear something besides their own hearts, they thought they heard singing in the sky.
that also scared them until they heard the words of the song that the angels were singing. Don't be afraid. Angels often say that, but it's because it's scary to have a messenger of God come to you. The angels were singing something like this. Don't be afraid. We bring you tidings of great joy, peace on earth, and goodwill to everyone. A child is born. Go, hurry, run to Bethlehem to see the child who will change everything. When the shepherds arrived at the barn, they were overwhelmed with surprise and love when they saw the little family. The parents, Mary and Joseph, looked at each other with surprise when they saw the shepherds and the sheep. They knew the shepherds and the sheep were part of their family, and they knew God was doing very special, even if it seemed very strange.
The Magi from Matthew chapter 2. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews?" And there, ahead of them, went the star that they had seen at its rising until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road.
Hundreds of thousands of miles away, a wild star flew through space and began to shine its light over the little town. In a faraway city, the wise ones saw the wild star flying through space. The wise ones knew so many things people thought they were magic, but the one thing they knew the most about was the stars. They knew they had to follow the star because it meant that a very special king had been born. They decided to bring gifts to this king, gold, sweet-smelling frankincense, and bitter myrrh. They came from so far away, they are always late. We tell their story because they traveled so far and brought so much love. We tell their story because we want to be just like them. We travel to Bethlehem every year in songs and stories and bring our gifts to this very special baby. We don't bring gold or valuable spices, but we bring love, the most valuable gift in the world.
The Light of Christ from John chapter 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as of the Father, as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Big thanks to our young friends who helped tell us the story of Jesus' birth this night.
Joining our voices with the heavenly host and Christians throughout time and space, let's pray for the church, the world, and all in need. Love proclaims that a Savior has been born to us. Inspire your church throughout the world to proclaim the good news of Jesus' birth to all who seek salvation and hope. Merciful God, love whispers to a weary world that the time for rest and restoration has come. Maintain healthy cycles of wake and sleep for all creatures. Where light pollution disrupts natural rhythms, encourage new practices. Merciful God, love cries to a warring world that the time for peace is at hand. Direct those in power who make decisions on behalf of others that they nurture and sustain all that is healthy, good, and holy. Merciful God, love sings through the wails of a newborn baby. Respond to all who cry out in pain, despair, or need this night. Bring comfort to those for whom separation, grief, or loss makes this Christmas season especially difficult. Merciful God, love murmurs words of comfort to a newborn child and exhausted parents. Bless new and expectant parents or caregivers, especially those who are alone or afraid. Pour out your love upon families of every kind this night. Merciful God, God's ever-present love is proclaimed through the faithful who came before us. We give you thanks for Mary, John the Baptizer, Elizabeth, his mother, Joseph, the dreamer, and all who point toward your love. Merciful God, rejoicing in your word made flesh among us, we commend these prayers to you, confident of your grace. and may the peace of Christ be with you all. Merry Christmas, and share a sign of that peace with those around you.
Please stand as you are able so that we may bless this offering. Gracious God, your word made flesh brings harmony to the earth. As we offer ourselves and these your gifts, prepare us to receive the grace and truth you offer at this table, and renew us in the song of your salvation. In Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. At this time, we'll gather around this table for God's holy meal. You'll want to find your cup of juice or wine and wafer. You won't open it quite yet, just find it. We'll say the words of institution, we'll speak the Lord's Prayer, and when I say, taste and see that the Lord is good, we will all open our wafer together and partake in the body of Christ, and then after that, we'll open our juice or our wine and partake in the blood of Christ. The Lord be with you.
And also with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. We give you our thanks and praise, O God, for you came as our salvation, a baby laid in a manger. And the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for remembrance of me." Gathered into one, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Love has come. God's love for all people. Come and eat. For Christ invites you here. Taste and see that the Lord is good. The body of Christ given for you. The blood of Christ shed for you. Let us pray. We thank you, wondrous God, for Jesus, God with us, in these gifts of bread and wine. As we have shared this feast of love, strengthen us to share your love with all the world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. A reading from Jan Richardson, How the Light Comes. I cannot tell you how the light comes. What I know is that it is more ancient than imagining, that it travels across an astounding expanse to reach us, that it loves searching out what is hidden, what is lost, what is forgotten, or in peril, or in pain. That it has a fondness for the body, for finding its way toward flesh, for tracing the edges of form, for shining forth through the eye, the hand, the heart. I cannot tell you how the light comes, but that it does, that it will, that it works its way into the deepest dark that enfolds you. Though it may seem long ages in coming or arrive in a shape you did not foresee. And so may we this day turn ourselves toward it. May we lift our faces to let it find us. May we bend our bodies to follow the arc it makes. May we open and open more and open still to the blessed light that comes. Stand and receive this blessing. The God of hope, fill us with all joy and peace in believing, so that we may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit, through Christ Jesus, the Word made flesh. Amen. Amen.
in peace. Rejoice in Christ our Savior. Thanks be to God.